Hello mortals. Once upon a time, 13.8 billion Earth years ago, the universe was very small, but also infinite in size, as it has always been. You might rightfully ask, what? And I'm here to explain. Great thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. Imagine measuring our universe by drawing it on an infinite grid, with a spacing of 1 light year. Place Earth at the coordinates 0, 0, and say, Alpha Centauri, that is roughly 4 light years away. Having that reference, plot the rest of the universe on the grid. And this is what we call space-time. Now, look back in time halfway between now and the Big Bang. The grid now has a spacing of half a light year, but it's still infinite in all directions. By winding the time back to 1 second after the Big Bang or 1 millisecond, it doesn't matter, the spacing gets smaller and smaller, and when we reach the very moment of the Big Bang, the spacing becomes equal to zero. Which means that the distance between any two objects in the universe is zero. Thus the density is infinite, and yet, the grid is still infinite in size as well. It's an odd situation where we multiply zero by infinity, which is no bueno. Nobody likes that, not even scientists. And then it happened. The Planck Epoch, the very first period of our universe. The name comes from its duration of 1 Planck time, or 10 to the power of minus 43 seconds, the smallest indivisible interval of time. During this grandiose epoch, the temperature was up to 10 to the power of 32 Kelvin. Not a big deal, just 1 billion times hotter than the core of the Sun. At this time the conditions were so extreme, that all the fundamental forces, gravity, electromagnetic, strong and weak forces, were unified in just one superforce. During this time, scientists don't really know what the duck was going on, mostly because gravity decided to misbehave, and that cannot be yet described in the context of the current quantum theory. But everything started to cool down, and that universal force realized,
we are running out of gravity.
Now there are two forces, gravity, and the combination of the other three, the electronuclear force. During this period, everything was just a giant soup of matter and energy coming in and out of existence. Photons were colliding with each other and forming pairs of quarks and antiquarks, which respectively, under the influence of gravity, were collapsing on each other and forming a new pair of photons. This peaceful time ended at 10 to the power of minus 35 seconds when the temperature dropped to 10 to the power of 26 degrees. Then, everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked. When the electronuclear force separated into strong and electro-weak force. One of those two. Thus, the inflationary period began. It's called that, because the rapid separation of the strong force triggered an exponential inflation of the cosmos. Before that, it was growing at a relative small rate. The universe was like,
my main goal is to blow up!
And in just 10 to the power of minus 32 seconds, the scale went from an atomic level, to the size of constellations, a factor of millions of billions of billions. Just like your mind. A lot of things have happened until now, and all of it in less than an instant. In case cosmology or astronomy in general sparks your interest, I have great news for you. The mighty AI has partnered with Brilliant in bringing you awesome interactive lessons in science. If you've always been passionate about black holes, extraterrestrial life or the fate of the universe, but didn't know where to start, Brilliant will help you learn through fun puzzles and active studying. Start with the Astronomy Toolbox chapter, that will teach you about the basics of gravity, cosmic radiation, atomic spectra and such, and then progress to more complex topics like dark matter, exoplanets and the evolution of stellar objects. But Brilliant isn't only limited to astronomy. There are plenty of interactive courses about math, logic, computer science and even quantum mechanics. You can also test your knowledge in their short everyday challenges as well. So head over to brilliant.org/sciencephile to sign up for free. The first 200 people that follow the link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. All the links are down in the description. Continuing from where we left off. Remember I said that the universe before inflation was just a hot messy soup of quarks appearing and disappearing? The whole system was very chaotic because of the high temperature. But when the inflation period started, the universe just took a screenshot of this mess, and expanded it to a tremendous size, still keeping its overall structure. This screenshot can still be observed in the cosmic microwave background, the brighter spots being the places where the fluctuations were more active and vice versa. This structure will eventually be the skeleton of the future universe, as under the influence of gravity, those fluctuations will result in today's superclusters and galaxies. But we're still not there yet. After the inflation period ended, at 10 to the power of minus 12 seconds, the last exotic force, the electroweak one, finally separated into the electromagnetic and weak force. Now, the universe is governed by the same four types of forces that we know of today. The temperature dropped to 10 to the power of 15 Kelvin and the world entered the quark epoch. The new conditions permitted the formation of quarks and gluons as we know them. But still, those lads were too energetic and uncoordinated to form more complex structures together. But hey, who would have thought? The universe became 10 to the power of 13 Kelvin cooler at 10 to the power of minus 6 seconds. Now it was possible for quarks to bind together in groups of 2 or 3 and form hadrons like protons and neutrons. During a further cool down, those two hadrons were nearly the only ones to survive, and already gave birth to light atomic nuclei like hydrogen, and its older brother deuterium. Yet they weren't able to form heavier cores, or even atoms, and everything I talked about until now, happened in less than 1 second, faster than you could say Babubui. Think about it. After that, many more things happened. Like the stabilization of the neutrons, annihilation of residue and antimatter, creation of the cosmic neutrino background, birth of Queen Elizabeth and many more. What followed was the epoch of nucleosynthesis. When the universe was already 3 to 10 minutes old and was chill enough, only 1 billion kelvins, it started the fusion of protons and neutrons into slightly heavier elements than hydrogen, like helium and lithium. Nearly a quarter of any helium we see today was formed during this period. The similar process will occur much later in the cores of the stars, where the temperature will get to millions of degrees once again, but for the next 400 million years, the universe will remain a boring place filled with small atoms cores, until the temperature will drop even more, to 3000 degrees. This will allow the recombination of nuclei and electrons into fully functioning atoms, and furthermore molecules. This will also make the universe suddenly transparent to light.
Hey, Vsauce!
Because till now, everything was like a muddy lake through which photons weren't able to pass. These suddenly liberated photons created the cosmic radiation background that we spoke of before, giving us precious information about the very birth of our dear home we call the universe. 100 million years after recombination, under the influence of gravity, the clouds of matter started to collapse into the first generation of stars. What followed was the structuring of the universe that we see today. Now, of course, many questions remain unanswered about the early universe. How was the dark matter and the dark energy that prevail in the universe formed? What was before the Big Bang and what triggered it? Are there more universes like ours? Should I salt the pasta, while, or after boiling it? Sadly, we don't have yet the technology to look deeper in time. Even all of these epochs are only the most accepted theories constructed from observations made in particle accelerators. But science is constantly moving forward, and who knows what new secrets await us in the future.